with the points and one is without the points. You either have a team that you're either laying the favorite or taking the underdog with points, and then you may want to just bet the money line where there's no points involved whatsoever. So that would be a separate bet completely.
All right, so let's say you have the same team, the Miami Dolphins, and they're getting plus five. The point spread bet is you're taking Miami plus five, you'd add the five to the final score, you either win or lose. Money line, that same team, now you get no points, you have to win outright. What might the odds be on a plus five?
That is absolutely correct what you're talking about. You might be getting then maybe plus $2.50, $3, or 3-1 for your money.
So you put $100 down, if they win outright, you'd win $300, $400. But if they lose even by 1 point, you lose.
That is absolutely correct.
Okay. And then there's the more exotic bets, parlays and teasers. How do those work?
Those work. You can bet two-team parlays, three-team parlays, all the way up to 10, mm-hmm. if you'd like. And the odds different and vary as you go on.
But a huge payoff for 10.
Absolutely a huge payoff for 10.
But whoever hits them?
Some people do.
Very few. Otherwise, they wouldn't be building those big casinos.
Very true. But it is out there for the customers. And they do like playing them. They like playing teasers also, which is a different kind of a bet also.
How does a teaser work?
Teasers work. You can either add, you can have 6-point teaser, 6.5, or 7-point teaser. Either add that to your team or deduct it from your team, depending on who's favored in the game.
All right, a three-team parlay, which is probably the most common parlay that bettors make. What are the odds of hitting a three-team parlay? What does it pay?
It does pay 6-1, and a lot of people do hit that at times. Mm-hmm. And so you're getting 6-1 for your money.
Well, it's realistic because you can win three teams, but to try and win 10 teams, the problem is, and I've seen it happen so many times, you're on a hot streak and you win 7 out of 10 games that day. Me as a professional, what a great day, right? 10 picks, 7 of them win. But 9 out of 10 doesn't even win on a 10-team parlay. You got to win every single one of them, and it doesn't happen very often.
Doesn't get the money. You're exactly right, Wayne. And you should be really the best way to play it is, of course, individual games.
Right.
That's the best way
to do
it.
That's the way a professional does. I don't ever play parlays, by the way. Explain VIG or juice to the people sitting at home who don't understand. I make a $100 bet at the betting window. I have to put down 110. What does that mean?
You're putting down $110 to win 100. The VIG is what we bookmakers call the VIG is the juice. In a perfect world, if you have a game, you would like to have equal balance of money on either side, but that usually never does happen. But the VIG is the juice and that you would be laying, whether it's 110 to win 100, 220 to win 200, and so on and so
forth. But you only pay it if you lose, because you may be laying it out in advance, but you get it all back if you win.
Absolutely correct again, Wayne.
So losers build those casinos. Right? I know you don't want to say that, but okay. Why do point spreads move? We just talked about it. Why do they move? What makes a game go from 3 to 4?
It does move because of the money being wagered on that team, one particular team over another. Or there might be a key injury that might come late, as far as news that might
but
come.
But mostly it's the money that
mostly
moves.
You're absolutely correct. It is the money.
So if I walk in and you respect me and I'm a smart guy, I'm a wise guy, as they say, a professional gambler, and I bet $10,000 on the Dallas Cowboys, and it's the Cowboys -3, there's some chance, just because of my one $10,000 bet, for the next guy who comes to the window to bet $10, you may make it Dallas -3.5, correct?
Absolutely correct. Again, we definitely look at serious professional gamblers, whoever's making the bet. That's certainly a big, important part of being a bookmaker in this business. Mm-hmm. But, you know, if you laid the 3 with Dallas, and the next customer who was only betting $10 would mm-hmm. be laying 3.5, possibly 4.
Mm-hmm.
We show a lot of respect to the professional gamblers.
To Wayne Root. Now, and by the way, let's use that exact example. Dallas goes from 3 to 4, and I bet $10,000. Does my line change?
No, your line does stay the same. You got it at -3, so when the number does move, and it might not move maybe for an hour or 2 hours later, maybe the next day, and if it goes to 4, you laid 3, and that's what you got at the time you made your bet.
Right. Even if there's a catastrophic injury and the line changes radically, you're stuck with the bet you made. Is that not correct?
You are absolutely correct again.
And that's why I, as an underdog bettor, by the way, and a professional who knows things can happen, tend to make my bet at the last possible second before the game starts, because I know about the injuries, I know about any sort of changes, but more importantly, as an underdog player, aren't you always better off waiting to the last second? Because you know the money's going to the favorites.
The smart money or the smart gambler, so to speak, always does wait to the last minute.
Okay. What about buying a half point? A lot of gamblers like me like to buy the half point. Games at +2.5, I want to make it +3 because that protects you against a field goal. Can you do it at the Plaza as an example?
You can do that at the Plaza and also other sports books around town. You're always laying 6 to 5. Usually, though, you don't buy on or off 3 or 7. Those are key numbers, but any other number you can do that.
But explain, a typical bet is 11 to 10, so laying 6 to 5 is a lot more expensive. It's 10% more expensive.
That is correct.
You're paying 20 cents at every dollar if you lose.
Instead of 10 cents.
Okay. The other question is, do I need to collect my winnings that day? The typical amateur comes to Vegas, he wins $1,000 that weekend, he goes home, he's got his winning tickets. Can he send them in 3 months later?
All the information is on the back of that winning ticket. Wayne has the plaza address on it and where to send that ticket. It's good for 120 days, and you can mail it in, and don't worry about being paid.
All right. And I never worry about getting paid in Las Vegas. I worry about getting paid offshore. I worry about getting paid from a guy in a bar. And I guess that's why Las Vegas is Las Vegas, because you can trust in big names, incredible names like the Plaza Hotel and Casino.
Absolutely.
All right. What are the betting limits at a place like yours, the Plaza Hotel and Casino? What's the most I can walk in and bet on a college game, on an NFL game?
Well, usually it does vary, but on college we're taking right now about $1,000 to a number. On the NFL, about $2,500 to $3,000. It just depends. With you, I might have to lower those limits because I do respect you a lot.
And if you go to the Strip, to one of the big, fancy joints, they're going to take much bigger bets than that. Is that not correct?
Absolutely correct.
As much as?
Some places up to $100,000, if not more.
Okay. And why would they take more? Why do you take more on an NFL game than you're willing to take on a college game?
Well, I think a bookmaker's a little bit more knowledgeable in the NFL. There's certainly more of that information that's out there. Not that we're not as knowledgeable in college, but so many, there's a lot of different players in college, whereas in the NFL, we're really zeroed in on that and really focused on it.
And that's probably why as a professional sports handicapper, actually like college much more than the NFL, because I feel like I have a slight edge over you guys, but in the NFL, you guys have even the playing field.
That's why you have the winning edge.
I have the winning edge, that's true. Last question, what's the biggest bet that you've ever personally taken as a legal sports bookmaker?
It was $500,000 in the Super Bowl, won one and lost one.
Now those must be painful to take, though. That's pretty scary. You're watching that game on pins and needles, right?
It was quite an experience, but it was a lot of fun also.
Awful lot of people have to come to the window and bet $10 to make up for a $500,000 loss, though, right?
Absolutely correct.
All right. Lou D'Amico, Racing Sportsbook Director, Barrett Gaming, Plaza Hotel and Casino. Thank you. You are truly a pleasure to deal with. Wayne Allen Root for the winning edge. Thank you very much.